Hello student, today we are going to study the error detection and correction basics. So, introduction, that is the network must be able to transfer the data from one device to another with the acceptable accuracy. For most of the application, the system must guarantee that the data received are identical to the data transmitted, so you can call it as a faithful communication, where the data received is similar to the data transmitted. Any time data are transmitted from one node to the next node, and they can become corrupted in the passage. So due to the channel interference or due to the channel noise, the data may get corrupted. Many factors can alter one or more bits of the message. Some applications require some mechanism for detecting and correcting the errors. So that's why the error detecting and correcting techniques are required. Error detection and correction has great practical importance in maintaining the data integrity across the noisy communication network channel and less than a reliable storage media. So for that purpose, the error detection and correction is required for the maintaining the data integrity across the noisy communication channel or network. Why error detection and correction required? Because of authentication, distortion, noise and interference, the errors during the transmission are inevitable and leading to the corruption of the transmitted bits. So due to the noise environment, the transmitted bits may get corrupted, and the longer frame size and the higher probability of the single bit error, the lower is the probability. So that's why it is required. And as well as the receiving a frame without error, that is the probability of receiving the frame without error increases with the size of the frame, and also the probability of the single bit error increases. This clarity emphasizes the need of the error detection and correction techniques. Types of the error. There are the two types of the error, that is a single bit error and burst error. That is, whenever bits flow from one point to the another, they are subjected to unpredictable changes because of the interference, and that this interference can the shape of the signal, like that is the first one is the single bit error and second one is the burst error. In single bit error means only one bit gets corrupted. That is, one bit of given data, that is a byte, character or packet, is changed from 1 to 0 or from 0 to 1, and this error is common in parallel transmission of the data. So it is common in the parallel transmission. This figure shows that suppose this is the sent data, and this 0 is gets changed to the 1 due to the error, so the receiver will get this kind of the data pattern. Next, this is the single bit error. Now the turn to the multiple error or burst error. Burst error. The term burst error means that more than one bit gets corrupted. That is, two or more bits in the data unit have changed from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. This error is very common in serial transmission of the data. Suppose this figure, in this figure, the sending data is 01001001. Now 4 5 10 0 11. So in this, so this 0 and 0, so here 2 4 data or 4 bits of data gets changed to 0 to the 1. So this is the received bit pattern. So this is nothing but the more than 2 bits gets corrupted due to the noise. Now the error detection techniques. So there are many error detection techniques are there. Error detection is the sending of additional information so the incorrect data can be detected or rejected. So in error detection techniques, some additional data stream is sent with the data, original data, so that it may be useful for while error detection and correction. Error detection is the ability to detect the presence of the error caused by the noise and other impairments during the transmission from the transmitter to the receiver. Error detection uses the concept of redundancy. Error detection uses the concept of redundancy, which means adding the extra bits for detecting the error at the destination. The use of redundancy means to detect or correct the errors, we need to send the extra redundant bit with the data. So in error detection, some extra bits are used to detect and correct the data. The extra bits are discarded as soon as the accuracy of the transmission has been determined. If receiver checks or validate the received data is correct, then that extra bit will be discarded. This redundancy is the basic mechanism for detecting and correcting the error. The listed below are popular techniques for the detection, error detection. That is, the error detection techniques are simple parity check, two-dimensional parity check, checksum, and the cyclic redundancy check. So these are the error detection technique. So in error detection, normally this is the, suppose this is the data generating the function. This is the generating function, and these are the redundant bits. So the sender what do that the one frame is of the main data and the one is original added with the some redundancy check. At the receiver checks the whether redundant bit is available or not, and if redundant bit is acceptable, he discard that redundant bit and frame will be received. So this is the technique, that is a simple parity check. The parity check is the simplest and most popular error detection scheme. The parity bit is appended to the original bits to create an even or odd bit number. The source then transmits this data via the link, and bits are checked and verified at the destination. The data is considered accurate if the number of bits, that is even or odd, matches with the transmitted from the source. The figure below shows the concept of parity check. That is, suppose sender sends the data, calculate the parity whether it is even or odd. So whether it is even, so even parity indication is there. Whether it is odd, odd parity indication is there. This data will be sent to the transmission media. Again, that bits counts the bits whether it is as per the criteria or defining criteria is available, as per the defining criteria is there or not. So whether it is even or odd, so yes it is, so drop the parity bit and accept the data. So in this way, simple parity checks can be worked. Here is a simple examples. There are two types of the parity checking. One is the even parity and second one is the odd parity. Even parity means the number of bits are one, are the even. Suppose this is the data 101001. So 1001 and parity bit is 1. Okay. So number of ones are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is the even parity. And in case of the odd parity, the odd number of bits are the 1 odd and parity bit is 0. So 1010111, so 5, and parity bit is 0. So it is an odd parity. So for example, in this figure, so number of 1s are 1111 and parity bit is 0. So this is the even parity. Suppose this is, and suppose what was the receiver received by the receiver due to interference is 1 1, this bit 1 is changed with the 0 and parity bit is 0. So then the receiver is getting incorrect message because of the one of the bits had changed from 1 to 0. But by the time receiver counts the number of ones, so 1 1 1, so there is a 3 number of ones had changed from one number of ones, and will detect there is an error because have the odd result instead of the even. So even result should be sent, but due to the corruption, the one bit is changed from 1 to the 0 in this example. So receiver will get to know there is a error in the received bit because the error have the odd result instead of the even. The next one is the odd parity. The sender and receiver both get added on the sending the message with the odd parity, the number of ones and parity bit includes should be the odd. So here the 1111 and parity bit is also 1. So there is a odd parity. Suppose what was received by the receiver due to the interference or impairments is this single bit error. So this is the this one is changed with the 0. So 1111. So the receiver will get the even number of 1s. So receiver will know there is an error because once in the message is even, which ought to be odd based on their agreement. So this is the parity check. Next one is the multiple or burst error. The receiver not able to detect. In this case, the receiver will not able to detect the error because of after counting the number of 1s in the message, receiver will have the odd result, which is the line of their agreement. So 111, so which is the line of agreement. The advantages of this is the simple parity check can detect all single bit errors only. It can also detect the burst error only when the number of burst bits in the error is odd, or if there is odd number of bits. Disadvantage: the technique is not foolproof against the burst error that invert more than one bits, particularly if even number of bits are inverted due to the noise, then error is not detected and the receiver cannot specify which is the bit or error. To overcome this situation, two-dimensional parity check was introduced. So this is the two-dimensional parity check. This performance can be improved by the two-dimensional parity check, which is organizes the blocks of bits in the form of the table. The parity checks are calculated for each row. Each row parity check calculated, which is equivalent to the simple parity check bit. And the parity checks are also calculated from the all columns. Columns also parity check can be calculated. Both are sent along with the data. At the receiving end, these are corrupted with the compared with the parity bits calculated on the received data. Suppose this is the original stream. This stream is write into the table. So this is 1100111. So for the first block, there is a 5 number of ones with the parity. 6 number of ones with the parity. Next one, 1011101. So this is the odd parity. Next one, 0111001. So this is the even parity. Next one, 0101001. So this is again odd parity. So 1. So now, so next one, so XORing the all these bits. So in the first column, 1101. So number of ones are the odd. So 1. Here the number of ones are even. 0, 1. 110, 111. Here the number of ones are the even, so odd, 0, 1 and 0. So now this is the first bit, second bit, third bit and fourth bit, and the last one is the column parity. So it is added with the data. The advantage is that it increases the likelihood of detecting the burst error. Extra overhead is traded for the better error detection capability. But the disadvantage is if two bits in the one data units are changed and two bits in exactly at the same position in another data unit are changed, the checker cannot detect an error. Next one is the checksum. The data is first in the checksum. The data is divided into the K segment for each of M bits. The segments are added using the ones complement arithmetic to get sum. The sum of complemented to get the checksum. And the checksum segment is then sent along with the data segment. Suppose these are the two Suppose the following are blocks of the 16 bits. It's sent using the checksum of 8 bits. So this is the first stream, that is 10101001, and second bits is 00111001. So add these two, so you will get the sum 1111010. Complement this, take the ones complement of this summation. So zero, so triple one gets 0, triple 0, so it will triple 1 and 10, and do the ones complement of that number, so you will get this number checksum, and pattern is sent to the with after this 2, so you will get this kind of the checksum. At the receiver end, both receiver end both frames will be added, takes the ones complement of the added signal and summation of these two signals, that is 000 11001 and all ones, complement of the all ones. So you will get the complements of the all ones, it is a 0, means there is a no error, that is the pattern is okay. Advantages of checksum. Checksum detects the all errors involving an odd number of bits. It also detects the most errors involving the even number of bits and has lesser extra overhead compared to the two-dimensional parity checks. But the disadvantage is even the value of one word is incremented and the value of another word is decremented by the same amount, the two errors cannot be detected because sum and checksum remain the same. And also, if the value of several words are incremented but the total number of total change is multiple of the 65,535, the sum and checksum does not change, which means the errors are not detected. Next one, cyclic redundancy check. This is one of the most powerful and commonly used error detecting codes. The basic approach is like this. If there is a n bit block of bit sequence, sender generates the n bit sequence known as a frame check sequence. So the resulting frame consists of m plus n bits and exactly divisible by predefined or predetermined number. But the receiver divides the incoming frame by that number, and if there is no remainder, it assumes that there is a no error. And if the receiver divides the incoming frame by the same number, and if there is a remainder, so it assumes that there is an error. So this explanation can be verified by this block diagram. That is, sender sends the M data with N bits. And divisor is n plus 1 bits, so divide, so CRC bits will get created, let's say n bits, that data will be added with or paired with the CRC and it will be sent to the receiver. Receiver again divide the same data with the n plus 1 bit, that is a divisor. If there is a remainder, remainder is a 0, then accept the data. If remainder is not a 0, then reject the data. The remainder 0 means there is a no error, and remainder non-0 is then there is an error. So the polynomials of the x can be expressed as a, suppose there is a P11001. So it indicates the power of 2, that is first bit is the 2 corresponds to 2 raised to 0, second bit is correspond to 2 raised to 1, third correspond to 2 raised to 2, like this. So in this 11001, so it is a 1 constant, x raised to 0 0, x raised to 1 0, x raised to 2 1 and x raised to 3. So it can be, so CRC can be expressed as a x raised to n m of x divided by p of x, that is equal to quotient x q of x plus the remainder r of x divided by p of x, and it is commonly used divisor is divisor is x raised to 16 plus x raised to 15 plus x square plus 1 and like this. So advantages of CRC can detect all single bit errors. CRC can also detect the double bit errors if there is a 3 ones are there. CRC can detect all burst error if less than degree of polynomial, and CRC detects the most of the largest burst errors with high probability. Error correction. So up till now there is a error detection concept, but the error correction is also important. Error correction is the sending of additional information so incorrect data can be corrected or accepted. The error correction is additional ability to reconstruct the original error-free data. The basic two approaches are there, that is backward error correction by the retransmission. So means when an error is detected in a frame, the sender is asked to retransmit the data or frame, and this approach is known as the automatic repeat request techniques, ARQ techniques. And the second approach is the forward error correction. This process in which the receiver tries to guess the message by using the redundant bit. Redundancy is used in the transmitted data to not only detect but correct the error in the received bit data. Key idea is like this. Requirement for the error detection is a code is an error detecting code if and only if minimum distance between the two codes word is 2, and requirement for error correction is for a code to be error correcting, the minimum distance of any two codes must be more than 2 bits. Humming code. So humming code is the set of error correction codes that can be used to detect and correct the bit errors, and that can occur when computer data is moved or stored. So we can verify this by using the example. Suppose this is there is a data 100101, and calculating the redundancy or parity bits required. Since the number of bits is 7 and the value r is calculated as a 2 raised to r is greater than or equal to m plus r plus m 1. So r is here 3 is given. That is 2 raised to r m plus r plus 1, so 2 raised to 3 is greater than or equal to 7 plus 3 plus 1, so 8 is greater than or equal to 11, so 4 false. Suppose if r is equal to 4, so we can test for the r is equal to 4, so 2 raised to 4 is greater than 7 plus 4 plus 1, so 16 is greater than 12, so it is a true. So we can therefore the number of parity bits is equal to 1. Take the second example. Determine the position of various data bits and redundancy bits. The various R bits are placed at the position that corresponds to the power of 2, that is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 3 and 2 raised to 4, which gives 1, 2, 4, 8. So thus the packet looks like parity bits are 1, 2, 4 and 8. So R1, R2, R3 and R4 is placed at the first position, second position, fourth position and eighth position respectively, where the P stands for the redundancy bits or parity bits. Okay, so determine the values of R1, R2, R3 in this example, R4 using R1, R2, R3, R4 using the VRC, that is a vertical redundancy check, using the XOR operation. So the XOR operation, there is a 1, 1, 0 and 1, 0 different bit is there, so 1. So R1 is the VRC for the bits 13579. So at the place 13579 and 11. So there is a VRC bit. So at the position 3rd 10, at the position 3rd there is a 1 bit, 5th 0 7 1 9 0 11 1. So this first 1 XOR with 0, so 1. This 1 XOR with 0, so 1. Again this 1 as it is. So this 1 and 1 getting added, so 0. So this 1 as it is. So 0 XOR with 1, so it is 1. So RO1 is equal to 1. So like this for the R2. So R2 is a VRC for the bits R2, that is 2, 3, 6, 7, 10 and 11. So at the position 2, at the position 3, there is a 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 10, 0 and 11, 1. So do the same calculation, so you will get the R2 is equal to 0. R3 is equal to 0, R4 is equal to 1. So therefore the transmitted message will be 100111001011. The receiver side, if any data bit is changed, the receiver recalculates the parity bits for the received data bits and comparing the send the parity and recalculate the parity bits. The location of the bit in the error is identified and the receiver can reverse its bits and correct the error. So that is, the conclusion is, the error detecting and correcting codes are essential to computing all sorts of the communication. To detect and correct the errors, we need to send the extra or redundant bits with the data. Error detection is more tedious than the error detection. So humming codes is one of the most powerful and assured technique out of the techniques discussed in the detecting and correcting the errors. Thank you.